Now, this is a case study three where we have helped one of the top 100 printer and one of our customer who are also listed in PI 400. And they were having such a large accounts, like multi-million dollar accounts. And one of the account they had was a restaurant franchisee across the United States. They were having 800 plus locations. And this printer already having multiple web to print technologies like XMPI, EFI, even in-house data centers, they were in verge of losing this multi-million dollar account because this restaurant franchisee required a unique way of online ordering and really highly secured ordering platform. So they wanted to secure their brand collaterals. They wanted to give variety of user level accesses depending on the user rights and user level, as well as they had a lot of custom documents, videos, manuals for 800 locations, franchisee owners. They wanted to showcase in iframe. Even they wanted to showcase some of the items from the restaurant main site. And some of the critical and secured items and collaterals were like menus. They didn't want to allow any of the users or franchisee owners to change the pricing without any authentication. So they also wanted some kind of authentication via SMS, via email, whenever somebody requests some changes onto a brand collaterals. So we did a multiple POCs with this customer along like 2 to 3 months. And then we also given them a complete POC proof of concept store. They also demoed to their large customers and they approved it. And we provided them a complete customized solution where they're able to quickly set up the franchises. And in the back end, we have integrated like AnFocus, the warehousing, like 3PLs, a lot of stock items which are ordered by restaurant franchises are directly updated in the 3PL. Plus, they had a lot of complex tampered requirement like menu items where we have also integrated Chili Publish, and we are also passing some of the data collected by users in XMPI. So still the variable data print and some complex tampered personalization is happening into an XMPI. So let me showcase how we have helped this customer retain this multi-million dollar restaurant franchisee account in our sample store. So this is a private store for the restaurant. Here, a lot of users are given an access, and depending on their roles and responsibilities, like a normal employee accounts, as well as franchisee owners, franchisee managers, regional managers are given an account. They also open an online registration for any new joinees or new employees, but it goes into an approval process. So they do not get any access without an approval. So let me first show you how we have helped this customer to differentiate these many user accounts and user labels. So in the back end, this is a corporate admin panel for the restaurant. And here they have created multiple locations. So this franchisee and restaurant had 800 locations. So similarly here, all the locations are created as a department, and within each department there are multiple users. So each of the customers are segregated within these departments. Now they also have a payon account and budget and cost centers allocated with each of these locations. Locations depending on their size are given a payon account and budget requirement. Now many of their customers are normal users, and many of them are restaurant franchisee owners as well as managers, and many of them are regional managers who has access to multiple locations. So they also have a state-wise managers as well as regional managers. So in this customer section, they have an access roles. So they are giving these access roles to the regional managers as well as many of the higher level managers here. So for example, if any of this user they are creating and they want to give an access to multiple location, because this particular restaurant has multiple location, like 80 plus locations are created here as a sample. So if this user needs an access to multiple location, they can simply give location access to them. So now this user would have access to all these locations. They can order on behalf of these locations. Plus they can be also given an order approval rights. So if this regional manager also needs to approve the orders of all the employees or the restaurant franchisee employees, they are able to approve it, and they can be given a super approval or a partial approval. So this is how they have created variety of departments, customers. They have logged in all the addresses of this particular corporate. So when they're ordering and having it shipped on a specific location. Plus using these personalization options, they have been able to personalize the login page of a restaurant. The unique URL has been given, and they're also using some custom CSS and theme configuration to make this store unique look and feel for this particular customer. And above that, they have corporate profile and user profiles are also created, which helps them to save a lot of time in personalization, because whenever user enters, their first name, their designation, even their photo IDs, store opening time, employee numbers, a lot of informations are auto-populating onto a template. And here, the corporate profile is dynamic. They're able to create an address book or required fields as per the requirement. And they're also able to import all the user details and the profile via Excel. So they have taken a very small amount of time setting up this corporate, because it's an easy way of creating corporates in the backend. And they have been creating this unique rules as well as user accounts from the backend. Plus they have an approval rules. So many of the time they want to skip an approval on a specific conditions, they are also able to do it. And they have also a lot of stock items offered to them. So they are storing those items into an inventory. So now let me show you on the storefront how a variety of users are able to access. Now, first of all, I'm logging in as a normal user. So as soon as I log in, I am a normal employee. So I'm only given an access to one particular location. So Claire is a employee at the New York branch. When she logs in, she only gets to see whatever is available to a specific branch. But then let me log in as one of the manager account. A manager has an access to multiple locations. So Rhonda is a manager. As soon as she logs in, she is able to see multiple location. And when she clicks on a particular location, she is also an approval manager. So she also sees orders placed by the New York employees, and she is approving any of the orders placed by the employees under her. So here she is able to see the order details that one employee has placed an order for window clings, and if she needs to approve, she can approve. And there are multiple approvals are also set. So after Rhonda, there is a Catherine manager, she will approve. So first she is approving, and then this email approval will go to Catherine, and now Catherine will approve. So Rhonda is having a location access up to 3, but then they also have some regional managers. Regional managers are people who are handling multiple locations. So when Catherine logs in as a regional manager, she is able to see multiple locations. Now she has been given almost 15 to 20 different locations. So anytime she wants to check variety of locations and even order on behalf of other locations, she is able to do it. So many of the time restaurant and franchisee owners are ordering directly through the regional managers. Many of the times they are not ordering. Sometimes they email them placing an order. So she is also able to order on behalf of any location. Plus, because she is a regional manager, she is able to select any location and can see all the orders placed by from that location and from all the employees under that location, whatever orders are placed, she is able to track and see it. So anytime if somebody required an old orders or the past orders or reordering, she just select the location and she is able to see all the orders placed from each location. So she is also able to see her order as well as any location has been assigned. So regional managers are having access to multiple locations. Now here, because it's a restaurant and franchisee, they're ordering a lot of predefined, printed and stock items. So here variety of templates are set, starting from business card to ID card, even the white format like window clings, calendar, flyer, one sites, postcards, and they're also ordering many of the kit items. For the new joinee, they're also able to order it directly kit. So as a restaurant, if they have a new employee, they're able to order the t-shirt, caps, and multiple items, and they're ordering a custom kit. And because it is like stock items, these are all showing them a quantities. Now these stock items, they are managing via 3PL. So these stocks are constantly updated in 3PL. And if they're adding a new stock, automatically these stocks are getting updated.